by video, stand by audio, stand by lighting. We are recording in 5, 4, 3. Hello everybody, Colin and Riley here at the Charleston Gaillard Center. And today we are setting the stage with our friend John.
Hey everybody.
So John, what do you do here at the center?
I am the head audio technician here at the Charleston Gaillard Center.
And what do you got to show us today, John?
Well, today I'm going to show you a little bit about one of the most important parts of my department, the microphone. Have you ever wondered how sound is able to be taken from one location and then played through a speaker, TV, or phone? Well, that journey starts with the microphone. Now, where is my microphone? Riley, have you seen it? Anytime you make a sound, whether it's singing, clapping, or playing an instrument, you are creating sound waves. Now, a microphone converts sound waves into electrical energy. That electrical energy is sent through a complex system of cables, consoles, amplifiers, and speakers so that sound can be heard in other places. There are many types of microphones. You can see a couple examples surrounding me on my micro throne. I've got here in my hand a Shure SM58, one of our most common microphones used for vocals. This microphone is a dynamic microphone. There are different types of microphones, but today we will be looking closely at how a dynamic microphone works. There are three main parts of the microphone: the diaphragm, the coil, and the magnet. Now, all of these parts are very small. If I take off the windscreen, all of these parts are right in here inside the microphone. The diaphragm is a thin material that is suspended inside of the microphone such that sound pressure from the wave can cause it to move. Imagine the diaphragm is like a trampoline and the sound wave is like you jumping on the trampoline. The coil is made of electrically conductive wire wrapped up. It kind of looks like a slinky. It is attached to the diaphragm and moves with it, up and down, in and out. The coil and diaphragm together are in an electrical field created by the magnet. Have you ever played with magnets? So magnets have two sides and will either pull themselves towards another magnet or push away from it. The magnet in our microphone wants to push the coil away from it, causing it to bounce back after sound pushes it towards the magnet. A sound wave changes pressure as it goes up and down. The raised parts of the sound wave are high pressure, and the dipping parts of the wave are low pressure. As the sound wave hits the microphone, they are causing the diaphragm of the microphone to move. The high pressure parts of the sound wave push the diaphragm towards the magnet, and the low pressure parts of the wave, working with the magnet, allow the diaphragm to bounce back the other direction. While the diaphragm is pushing in and bouncing back, the coil of wire connected to the diaphragm moves with it. As sound waves move the coil towards the magnet and then are pushed away, this motion creates electrical energy. That electrical energy is then sent out over a cable. And our microphone has created a signal which travels through many pieces of equipment until you hear it coming out of your speaker.
So, the next time you listen to your favorite singer or talk on the phone, think about how that microphone is helping you do that and what it is doing to the sound. Thanks, John. And thank you all for joining us on Setting the Stage here at the Gaillard Center. See you next time.
Thanks, guys. High five, Riley. Yeah.